Hi all, I am Radhakrishnan, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering, Hawkins Institute of Science and Technology, Cochin. Today, we are going to discuss about these true threat measurements using profile projector, which is a prescribed part of screw threat measurements in the module 3 of KTU syllabus. Before going to the measurements, we can have an introduction about these instruments. So this instrument is called profile projector, and it has an illuminated light source in the bottom in this cabin. Then light is projected and it is passing through a collimating lens, collimator, and through a green filter. That is why the color you can see that it is green. Then the object whose threat parameters is to be measured is kept on this table, and it is an opaque object. When light is passing through the opaque object, then we will get the shadow of this component. The shadow is captured by this lens. Here this is 20 times magnification lens. That is why the shadow of this component is captured by this lens and is magnified 20 times and is projecting to the screen. We have many options, 20 times magnification, and we have also 10 times magnification lens. So here we are using, because the component is small, we are using 20 times magnification lens. About this measurement, it is a coordinate measuring. So this is called Y direction, that is micrometer head which is having the measurements in Y direction, and this is X direction. This micrometer measures the dimensions in X directions. So we have this micrometer, we know that it is 0.01 least count. This is also 0.01 least count and X and Y direction. And also we have an anchor measuring vernier setup is there. This is a disc with vernier attachment. So here this one is 0 to 360 degree graduations, and the vernier is given here, and its least count is 1 by 60 degree, that means 1 minute. 1 minute is the least count, so that we can measure the angles up to 1 minute least count, and the linear dimensions or dimensional accuracy or will be 0.01 mm with the help of this micrometer. So first of all, we can go for the major diameter, that is we have major diameter, minor diameter, pitch and included angle. The four parameters we can measure using this instrument. And one more important parameter, mean effective diameter, that we cannot measure with this instrument, because mean effective diameter we have to use wire method, single wire, two wire and three wire method. But major diameter, minor diameter, pitch and included angle can be measured with this setup. So first of all, I am going for the major diameter measurement. Major diameter means the distance between the crest of one side of the thread and to the crest on the other side of the thread. So first of all, you can see that there is a crosswire setup in the disc, in the screen. You can see the crosswire setup. First of all, I am bringing to all the crest on the one side of the thread to coincide with this reference axis. Say I am making points of the X axis. You can see that. Again, minor adjustments can be used, can be done using this arrangement. So now all the crest of the thread on one side is making exactly coinciding with the crest on the one side, and the reading is noted down. It is from the micrometer, it reads as 7.04. So the main scale reading is 7 and thimble scale reading is say 4. Since the least count is 0.04, the total reading will be TSR plus TSR into least count, that is 0.01. So the total reading will be 7.04 mm. So the initial reading is taken as 7.04 from this micrometer, and with reference to this, I'm going to the moving to the other side, so that all the crest on the other side may coincide with the reference axis, same reference axis, say X. Now it is coinciding, and I am getting this reading as 10.5. It is 10.5 plus 0.43. So this is final reading is 10.5 point, this is 43. So this comes around 10.93. Come on. If you find the difference between these two, you are getting 11. This is 11. This is 11 mm. 43. 11.43 is the reading. So we are getting nearly 4.5 mm. Four point three nine mm is the major diameter. Then we can take 5 or 6 or 7 trials, keeping that initial reading and final reading. Then we can take the 5 different readings, then average it. You will get the difference between these two, major and minor diameter, as the major diameter of the thread. For minor diameter, we have to coincide with the reference axis with the root of the thread. That means the trough or all the troughs in the one side of the thread, which may coincide with the reference axis, and the initial reading is taken as 11, so main scale reading, and 13.41. So that means 11.41 mm. Next, I am moving to the other side, and all the roots of the thread may coincide with the reference axis, that is X axis. Then we are taking the final reading as 8 mm, then 6, so 8.06. So we will be getting 3.35 mm. So this is the minor diameter we can measure with this profile projector. Next, we are going for pitch. For pitch, which is the distance between two corresponding parts, between two corresponding points, between two consecutive threads. So, suppose if you are taking crest to crest, root to root, or any other point on a thread, the same corresponding part on the very next thread, that is that distance between these two corresponding parts, between adjacent threads, is called pitch. Now I am taking the reference axis, y axis now, and this reading is noted down from the crosswise micrometer. So I am getting as 5 mm here 1.4, so 5.14 mm is the initial reading. Next, I am moving to the very next thread, same point, that is tip of the crest, and I am taking the reading as 6.0 6 ohm here, 39, so 6.39, and the difference between these two will be 1.25 ohm. Hence, all the parameters, major dia, minor dia, and pitch is measured using these two cross micrometer heads, that is X and Y. Here pitch is moving in this direction, that is why we are taking this Y axis as the reference. For major and minor diameter, the component is placed longitudinally, so this is the reference, the X axis is the reference, that is we are taking initial reading, final reading with the reference, taking a X axis as a reference. Next, we are going for angle measurement, included angle. Included angle is the angle between two flanks of the consecutive threads. So here we are taking this circular disc for the measurement. So one of the line of is making into parallel with the flank of one side, and the reading is noted down from here. This is 289 plus this is 289, and since it is a vernier and it's matching division, coincident division, the vernier is 16th division is matching exactly. So one division, least count is 1 minute. So 289 degree, 16 is the coinciding division. So total reading will be 289 degree 16 minute. This is the initial reading. Now I am tilting the same wire
for the cutting. I'm stopping it.